Hi, I'm Jim Booker with HorizonHobby.com. Welcome to my little how-to here today. Recently, I have done a preview article covering the Align 450 Pro helicopter. Now, this is a very cool helicopter, but one of the things you find out right away in flying in helicopters is you really need a transmitter timer to tell you how much time you've been flying your helicopter, because you tend to lose track of just how much time you've been running the motor, and certainly with a helicopter, you don't want to run out of power while you're, 50 feet in the air or something. Well, I had borrowed a JR-12X transmitter from Mr. John Denise, our JR category manager, and he was kind enough to let me use it. But I found a neat feature in there, because I know a lot of guys are like me. I cannot remember to start the timer when I, you get out there, you get excited about flying, you lift off and you're flying, you say, oh man, I forgot to turn the timer on. Well, the 12X will let you do a little thing that it gets around that. You can assign the timer start to the transmitter throttle stick. Anytime it comes off idle, the timer starts running. Now, the conventional way with a glow airplane is once you start the timer, you don't want it to stop, you want to time the flight. But with an electric airplane or an electric helicopter, you really want to time the amount of time that you've been using the motor power, and as a result, you can tell how much time you got left to fly. Well, the JR-12X does this thing, allowing us to start this thing by advancing the throttle. Anytime it's off idle, it's running, and of course, you can take a look at it, see how much time you've used. But if you land, for instance, and you shut the power off for a second, it'll shut the timer off. So it's only timing the amount of time the motor's been running. Now, let's go through the process. It's really pretty simple, but I don't think it's well covered in the manual, but I think it really is pretty easy to use, and it's a heck of a neat feature. I've added it to all my other helicopter memories now as well. Okay, let's turn the transmitter on, and we're gonna turn it on in a mode where, it's called system mode, where you would normally select the model memory that you wanna use. So I'll turn it on. Now we're in the system mode list. But we're not going to select a model. We're going to do this thing called a stick position switch. This is something we don't normally use, but in this case, it's going to help us out a lot. Now, as you can see, you can actually select four different stick positions. But we're going to select stick position 0, and we're going to select the throttle. Okay, now that we've got through that, there's some options. Well, what we want it to do is we want the stick position at low to turn the timer off. So we're going to set this down to 100, which would be the idle position. Okay, now you can select the on at any position in here, but we want on to be anything above that idle position, so we don't have to make a change there. As you can see right now, when we advance the throttle, the function will be on. When we're back to idle, it's off. One other function that you have a choice of here is what they call symmetry, and what that means is that if it was on, the timer would be, in this case, it would be off at both low and high. Well, we want symmetry off. Okay, we're going to move from here to the function mode. That's all we're going to have to do right there. So we're going to go back to the normal position and select the function mode. And we're going to go to the timer. We'll scroll over to timer. And we have to make a couple decisions here. You can see that there's more than one timer option. We have timer 1 or timer 2. But we are only worried about timer 1 right now. And I want a countdown timer, so I'm going to start here. Now, normally, the option here is that it would start with one of the various keys that you can use to start the timer. But I want to use that stick position 0 that we made available. It's right here. SPS0. Okay, it says the default is 10 minutes. I want 6 minutes. And I want to hear from this thing about every minute, so I'm going to have an interval of 1 minute. So each minute I'll hear a beep. And I also want to hear the countdown alarm as it gets near the end of my 6 minutes. And so I'm going to set that for 20 seconds. So at 20 seconds, it's going to start notifying me that I'm almost out of battery in this case, because I'm using an electric mop. Okay, so at this point, we're done. Let's go see how this thing works. Okay, we're showing 6 minutes. I'm going to advance the throttle, hear a beep, of course, and it's counting. And I'm going to stop the timer by going back to the idle position, like we're gliding or something, or powered down on our helicopter. But anytime I advance the throttle again, the timer keeps running. But if I come back to idle again, the timer shuts off. So what it's doing is it's only timing the motor run. Now, this is important in electric airplanes and maybe not as much in other kinds of models, but electric airplanes, electric helicopters, you really want to know how much time you got left in your battery, and so you don't get a surprise while you're, say, 50 feet in the air with your T-Rex helicopter. Anyway, try that out. I think you'll have a lot of fun with this one. This is something that I've been incorporating into all my model setups now. I hope this will help you out on this thing. I know it was a little confusing the first time I went through it, but it's really pretty straightforward. And I think you'll find this is very utilitarian. I'm setting it up on just about all my electric models at this time. So thanks for viewing our how-to. Let's see how you do with this thing. Let me know. Again, thanks for viewing horizonhobby.com.